Today is Europe Day, and if you didn't know it, don't worry, you're not the only one.
Do you know what Europe Day is?
Actually, I don't, which is really embarrassing for me, because I'm a really pro-European.
No.
And that is, what, the day the nymph got captured by the bull, or, like, no, what is that?
It's the Schuman Declaration.
That's the Schuman Declaration. Okay, I should know that. Sorry. Sorry.
The Schuman Declaration, named after a statement read by former French Foreign Affairs Minister Robert Schuman on the 9th of May 1950, is widely considered to be the founding text of the European construction.
The Schuman Declaration was the suggestion to build a European community of coal and steel, to combine coal and steel industries in France and Germany, and to avoid another world war.
What started out as a cooperation in the coal and steel industries eventually led to more and more economic integration between more and more member states. Treaty after treaty after treaty, the European Union progressively emerged. The economic project started out in 1950 is now a unique political entity whose main objective is to guarantee the freedom of goods, services, people, and capital.
Today, Europe Day is one of four symbols of the European Union. The other three are the European motto, United in Diversity, the European flag, and the European anthem. The thing is, very few people know that. A survey conducted in 2015 found that only 36% of Europeans can answer basic questions about the EU. Many believe this fuels Euroscepticism and are trying to change that through education.
I'm steps away from the European Parliament in Brussels, in front of the House of European History. It was inaugurated a year ago, and as the name indicates, it tries to explain European history through the common experience of different countries across Europe. The museum is set on six different floors with a lot of interactive animation, movies, and unique objects. This, for example, represents the entire body of EU law if it was compressed into one book. The creators of the museum wanted to fill a void in the way history is taught across Europe.
History is taught in schools according to the national model. Sometimes also regional or local history is taught, but never history from a European perspective.
Despite all these efforts, the European Union still has an image problem. Only 40% of European citizens trust the institutions. Many accuse them of being undemocratic, bureaucratic, pro-business, or unaware of people's daily reality. So while the different member states do share historical moments and references, it will take more than symbols like Europe Day for citizens to gain knowledge and trust in the European project.